Let's go.
Nobody's gonna notice you gone back at camp?
Saul has no wish to see us there anyway. The better to make a good second impression on the Biotechnica suits.
Your sour faces wouldn't help much.
Indeed, they would not.
The Raffens, what about them? You expecting any trouble?
Saul is. He's posted sentries all around the camp.
How's that not right?
He's wrong in continuing to fight the symptoms rather than the disease.
You don't miss life in Night City?
At times, perhaps. I miss the feeling of having a new beginning. Of freedom. But I also haven't forgotten the emptiness. The feeling of realizing it means nothing if you're alone.
Yeah. Took adjustment on my part, too. Though, never was completely alone.
You had someone?
A true friend. Jackie by name. You would have liked him, actually.
Jackie. I'll remember that. Arrived.
Big bastard.
If you like it so much, maybe we should just hijack the train. Let the basilisk go on its way.
Yeah, then just drive this beast to the 101. There and back.
Saul would be on board with that.
Are we ready? Okay. The Militech convoy will be traveling from Night City to the base where they're due to meet the buyer. We will stop it at the railroad crossing.
All we have to do is shove this beauty in its way.
V, any questions?
Plan to move this thing how exactly?
It's old tech. Carol will have to hack it.
Then I'll somehow have to finagle authorization from the control tower to move it.
Tower looks inactive to me too.
Yeah, we'll see to that. You and Pan Am just get the authorization code.
Okay, let's get to work. Huh, that was quick. Stairs it is, then.
Do you need a light?
Well done. Thanks, boys. Of trains. And the stations where so many tracks converge.
Junctions.
Yes, those. When you see them from above, you feel...
free. Like you could set off on 1,000 journeys all at once.
Perhaps more simply, hopeful.
Sure thing. Nada. Nothing here. Nada.
well.
Got something.
Good job. Carol! We have a card! What now? You have to put it in the reader!
Here goes nothing.
Imagine that could.
V, I wanted to speak with you.
Getting cold feet?
I am, but it has nothing to do with the convoy.
So what is it?
I know this may sound foolish, because I asked you to help me, but... why are you doing this?
Please note, the arrival of the next free train is delayed.
Not doing this for free.
Ah, you need another firearm.
Didn't mean a gun. Meant you.
If we're thinking of the same thing, then alas, I must decline.
See, to me, we've been on the same wavelength for a while now.
Yes, the same wavelength, different broadcast. That is not a currency I use to pay for favors. All right, let's rejoin the others.
Convoy, got eyes and ears on it?
Yes, Carol checks their communication channels from time to time. Everything is proceeding as planned. For now.
Sit your ass down a minute, honey. Breathe.
Everything's under control. The convoy is already heading our way.
Hurry up and wait, then.
We have quite some time left till dusk. Car could use another once over. The stars have emerged. We've but a few hours till dawn.
You're acting spooked. As if you're the first person ever to stand up to Saul.
Oh, save your breath. I don't need to be consoled. Was it someone I know?
New. Scorpion.
He came home from the war, head full of new ideas, and a host of new contacts.
He tried to get Saul to lead us in joining Snake Nation. It would make us stronger, he said.
I don't think he peeped a word of it to me. What did Saul do?
Saul dressed the guy down head to toe for messing with the family. Hell, he didn't send him on any jobs for a year.
Gee, really consoling. Thanks.
You said yourself you didn't need any.
Ought to raise a glass to Scorpion.
to Scorpion.
And to Jackie.
Gonna try and get some sleep.
Okay, it'll be quite some time before the convoy comes through.
You couldn't sleep if you tried, could you?
I'll just lie here a while, by your side, gazing at the stars.
Is that another area of your expertise? You got maps of the heavens in your library, too?
Of course. That's the Big Dipper. And do you see the small flickering star to the right?
Yeah.
You do? Oh, dear. That means there's a major leak. Good night, B.
Okay, here they come.
Is everyone ready? Let's ride, B. Get her up to speed.
They're going faster than we thought. I don't know if we can catch them.
Uncouple one of the cars. It'll speed you up. V, no hemming and hawing. Take out that coupler. Surround them as soon as they're cut off. Shit!
Me.
Probably jammed again.
Okay. The trucks are all yours, boys.
Move that ass, Teddy boy.
Go, go, go!
Four, no, five vehicles!
No, it's blocked! We need...
Come on, Slimstick!
Don't you worry. We're all on roll now.
Target!
We got it! Cover me! Reloading!
Hell yeah! They've got us picked out!
Leaving. You'd better move.
Sure did.
Just be happy you won't be around to put the hunk of junk together. The real fun is just starting. I can talk to him if you want.
No, thank you. I'll take care of this myself.
Fuck! Pan Am!
So it begins.
What's the meaning of this?
Exactly what you see. The Basilisk.
All I see is two trucks with giant Militech logos on them. Fuck, Pan Am! You can see them from miles away! You think we don't have problems enough on our hands? The Raffens could rear their heads at any moment! And now we have Militech to worry about, too!
Stop it! Fuck! Just shut up already! Do you want to serve corporations forever? Fine! Go right ahead! In that case, we'll leave the Basilisk as a souvenir of what this family used to be. But you know what? Maybe next time we're attacked, we'll be able to fight back!
As soon as I'm done with Biotechnica, we call a family meeting to discuss this. Discuss you. Until that time, I want these trucks out of my sight.
And the Basilisk? Can we put it together?
Do what you want. Just get out of my sight.
Bob, Mitch, you two take the trucks around back. We need to unload.
Sure, but then what do we do with them?
Oh, well, I've got an idea.
You got quite a pair of lungs there.
Thanks. I believe the last time I pulled something like that, I was 10 years old.
Seems to still be in fine working order. You need me again, all you gotta do is call.
V. I'm sure I will, so you better expect that call.
Be waiting. Take care.
Hi there.
Hey, Mitch. You doing okay?
Yeah, I'm doing all right, but, meh.
Let the rain.
So many dead. So many of them good friends, too. Do you know what it's like to lose your best friend?
Yeah. Name was Jackie.
Uh-huh. How'd he go?
Like everyone goes in Night City.
Anyway, come on. Help me out with something.
What?
Some loose ends. Final goodbye. I don't much want to do it alone.
Okay, I'll help.
Come on, then. You're okay behind the wheel, right?
Yeah, and?
We're going for a drive.
Uh-huh.
I need a power inverter.
And where?
Have you seen anything?
I can tell you're a city boy. You want to know everything. Now. Yesterday.
Thanks.
A little patience, V.
May they find peace.
Here in the Aldecaldos, it all stays in the family. Used to be Scorpion's, that rig. Now she belongs to me. And my old girl's right next to it.
Nice wheels. Both of them.
Damn right. Out here, those wheels are our life. I'll take Scorpion's, you hop in the other.
All right, let's go.
Let's hit the road. Follow me.
Mitch, you hear me?
Yep. But more driving, less talking.
Sun on my face, wind in my hair. Perfect.
Oh, hey. Haven't seen you in a while.
Not a fan of funerals.
Yeah. You and death don't really mix.
Say that like it's my fault. Never asked Saburo to put me on that fucking chip. Or for you to slot it in your head.
I hope this place is too far.
Speaking of, where are we going?
Not a clue.
My, what a good little boy scout. So trusting, so accommodating.
It's for Scorpion. His last wish or something. Is that good enough for you?
Great. Never a dull moment.
We're heading for the collapsed bridge. Other side of that hill.
Copy.
Almost there now.
Okay, copy. Holy shit, Mitch! What the hell?
Relax, V. It's what Scorpion wanted.
He wanted you to stuff him in the trunk like a spare tire?
No, he wanted me to take him here. And send him off with a bang. We set him up behind the wheel, douse the car, then light it, let him fly off the edge.
I mean, if that's what Scorpion wanted...
He did. Said it a million times, if he said it at all.
Grab me that can, will you?
Here you go.
Great. Go ahead. Put it in the passenger seat.
I see the driver is already behind the wheel.
No point wasting time. Another hour or two, and he'll puff up like a balloon. Right. Shall we get this show on the road?
Are you absolutely sure this is a good idea?
No, V. No, I am not. But it was my best friend's dying wish. So I'll do whatever the fuck I can to make it happen. With or without you.
Let's do it.
Hell yeah. I already got a rag in the can. You light it. I'll start the car.
She's burning! Quick, before she blows!
May the road be kind to you, friend. Out with a bang. Just like he wanted. Soot and ash. That much remains. So, how about a beer?
Sure. I'll drink to a send-off like that.
Well, come on. Ah, nothing like a good cold one.
Agreed. Mitch, why me? Why'd you ask me to help?
You seem like a good egg.
I'm serious.
I don't know, I guess the fact that I'm still here to send him off right. That's thanks to you. Your paths crossed. Just for a moment. But damn, was it the right one? Listen, there's a few things of his you ought to have. Like this little good luck charm. Go on, it's yours.
What is it?
Not a clue. Scorpion always had it on him, no idea why. Listen, I'm gonna sit here for a while, all right? Brood in peace.
Understood. I'll be off then.
Sure. Listen, if you want, you can take my car back to camp. Whatever works for you. Oh, and, thanks, V, for today. And for getting me out of that shit back then, too. You're all right. You're really all right.
See you around.
Bye, V. Remember, the media lies.
What are you carrying?
Firearms. Best in all the Badlands.
What did I just say? It ain't working, all right? What? No, it doesn't shoot, doesn't turn, doesn't do fuck all. Turn off and... Are you fucking kidding me?
Keep it together.
Nothing to be shy about! Nothing to be shy about!
Man, this transmitter takes me back.
How so?
Back in 2020, we used them for pirate broadcasts.